Hello everyone. Today we're going to take a look at how to make bookmarks in Canva to advertise different reading recommendations. These could be seasonal, they could be topical, it could be an author spotlight, it could be something related to a current trend in the media, anything that you think your library has resources about that you want to promote to your patrons. The process we're going to look at today is only going to work in Canva Pro because we're going to be using a custom size of the template that we're going to use to make the bookmark. Full disclosure here, I did not create this entire process. I am showing you what I have learned from one of my coworkers with perhaps a few tweaks and changes to what I had initially learned. So let me first show you some examples of recent bookmarks I created so you can see what the finished product is going to look like. I'm going to show you 5 different bookmarks I've created. Each bookmark is double-sided. Right now, we are looking at the single PNG file for both the first and second pages of each of the bookmarks. And I'll explain later how this single image gets put into the Word document so you can print 6 per page. I enjoyed the book, The Art Forger by B.A. Shapiro. And I wanted to give some read-alike recommendations. My patrons will likely enjoy one of these 3 books, all of which were on the library shelves somewhere within the county system. The front page of this bookmark asks if people want vibes similar to Lessons in Chemistry. Then they should try Broadband, The Friend, or Hidden Genius, and or Ninth Street Women. Here's one example of a seasonal bookmark. Flip for titles that give those Gilmore Girls and Stars Hollow vibes. Then I listed 3 different books that I felt had some kind of tie to the hit TV show. All the examples you've seen so far have to do with adult readers. I decided to bring this same process to the children's department and made an autumn bookmark of 4 different books listed here on the second page that are all in the children's department circulating collection. The last example is World War II Women. On the front page, there are 2 different books dealing with the roles women had during World War II, and another 3 books on the second page, making a total of 5 dealing with this one particular topic. Now let's take a look at the design process in Canva. On your Canva Pro main page, you'll click on Custom Size. It will initially say pixels. You'll need to choose inches. The width is going to be 2 inches and the height is going to be 8.5. This is going to be very similar to an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Click on Create New Design. Now you're looking at the first page of your one-sided bookmark. To make it a double-sided page, you'll click on Add. And your page 2 will appear beneath it. Here is where your imagination, your knowledge of your collection, and your creativity can really be let loose. I'm going to make a sample about Pulitzer Prize winning books because I'm currently reading Gone with the Wind. First, I'm going to type into this template search box to determine what I want the background of the first page and second page to be. It will automatically, as you see, move the image so it conforms to the 2 by 8.5, and then we have here our 2 pages. So I'm over here on Goodreads. I'm not going to limit myself to whether or not I'm looking only at hardback or paperbacks when I'm here in Goodreads. I just need a cover that looks nice. So we're going to right-click Copy, Control-V, Paste. I can get 4 on the back side of this bookmark and maybe 2 on the front side once I do some manipulation of this front page. I'm first going to get rid of the shadow. I'm going to move the little burlap area up to here. I can also, with any of these purple lines, change its size. I do like the ragged edge that you see, so I'm going to keep moving it until I have it where I want it. I can rotate any of the words, so I'm going to rotate this. This is where I'll put Pulitzer Prize, and I will also talk about a little about what that means. I can shrink down this so it fits right where I want it. Once you have both pages designed as you want, page one, page two, I'm going to click on Share, Download. PNG file is fine. You're going to do all the pages. By opening the zipped file, I have unzipped the contents. Now I have page one and page two as PNGs. Our next step is to open up a Word document, making the layout to be the landscape orientation and changing the margins to something really specific. Custom margins are going to be 0.5 for the top and bottom and 0.22 for the right and left. Now we're going to the unzipped PNG file. We are going to open page one. We're going to Control C copy. Go back into your Word document and paste Control V. Image itself needs to be manipulated a little bit to where we can get six across. The very first thing we're going to need to do in the picture format is crop the size of the image itself. The height will be 7.5 and the width is going to be 1.76. The wrap text is going to be tight and you'll need to go into more layout options. On the position subtab, your absolute horizontal position is going to be 0 inches to the right of the margin. Remember, we had a unique margin for the right and left of this particular template. So this absolute position to the right of the margin is going to be changing with each successive bookmark. You can now click on this first image, Control C, Control V. Change its layout, still height, see more. Absolute position now to the right of the margin is going to be a different number. For the second image, the absolute position is 1.76. Control C, Control V. The see more here when you click on this little height text wrapping will get you to the position subtab within layout a little bit faster on my particular version of Word. Image 3, absolute position 3.52. Image 4, 5.28. Image 5, 7.04. And image 6, absolute position 8.8. The process you did for page one, you're going to repeat for page two. Open the PNG file, Control C, copy into the Word document on page two. We already have a page two. Control V, paste. Now you'll notice that there is a third page. We're going to need to delete that with a backspace and then set up this image, text wrap. Height, more layout options, position, absolute, 0 inches to right of margin. You'll need to make sure that that is 0 inches to right of margin. So now you Control C, copy, Control V, this particular image, see more, absolute position for image 2, 1.76, Control V, image 3, absolute position 3.52, Control V, absolute position image 4, 5.28, image 5, absolute position 7.04, image 6, your last step is going to be to go to File, Print. When you're looking at a large industrial printer, you'll have a couple different properties than what I have shown here. Regardless, you are printing on both sides and it needs to be the short edge of the page. And then in the printer properties, you'll need to go into paper and quality. Your media will be thick paper or perhaps heavyweight paper. Your paper source is going to be manual feed or perhaps the bypass tray to ensure that cardstock rather than regular computer paper can be printed on both sides. Then you'll choose how many copies you want to make and you will print and then cut out your bookmarks.